Hey YouTube, it's Jen. Wanted to make my video for today. This is gonna be my week 11 video. Yeah, week 11, because actually next week's gonna be my 3 month post-op video, which I'm really excited. February 1st hits my 3 months, so that's awesome. I'm almost 12 weeks out. So let me start off with the statistics, and I have to try to remember what I weighed last week. So I'm opening up this application on my iPhone right now. Technology. What would, where would we be without technology? It's hard to remember those days, isn't it? Let's see. November 1st, I had gastric bypass RNY surgery. I started out at 316 pounds the day of surgery. I was 298 pounds. And today I weighed in at 247 pounds. I believe my last video I weighed 249. I think 249.4. Yeah. Something like that. So around a 2.5 pound loss for the week. Not as high as I would like, but I'm totally okay with it because I had dropped quite a bit of weight recently, and I'm expecting to stall. I stalled very early for a little bit, and I figure, you know, I'll probably drop a little weight, stall, drop a little weight, stall. I know Banded Pam, you experienced the same thing recently too, a stall. And unfortunately it's going to happen, you know, it's just a fact of the surgery, that it's a side effect. Your body needs some time to adjust. And, when you're losing weight as rapidly as you do on this surgery, then, you're going to plateau. Your body's going to need a rest for a little bit. So I'm fully prepared for that now. The first time it happened, it was fairly early on after my surgery, and it was a little nerve-wracking. But now I'm prepared for it, and I understand it's going to happen. So let's see. I've lost a total of 69 pounds in 97 days. That includes my pre-op diet. That it's a 21.8%. weight loss of my overall body weight, and it's an average of 0.7 pounds a day. And I would like to reach my goal in a year. So by November 1st, 2011, I'd like to weigh 165 pounds. That is my goal. I know that may seem high to some people, but I don't even remember the last time I weighed 165 pounds. That would just be like a crazy, ridiculous number for me, because I think I had to be like 10. I don't know. But in order for me to reach that goal in a year, I would need to lose 0.3 pounds a day going forward. And like I said, right now I'm averaging 0.7. And for anybody who has an iPhone out there and is doing this, I highly recommend this app that I got. It's really cool. It graphs your weight loss. It gives you statistics. You can record it in, you have a whole history of, you know, your weight loss, and it's called Track Weight. And I can't remember if it was free or if it was paid. I'm not 100% sure. You guys might notice I'm wearing my glasses today. Do I look very smart? I always think I look much more intelligent with my glasses on than I do when I don't. And being a dean at a college, I always like it when I can look smart, because I actually feel like I look very young, and some people have a tendency not to take me so seriously. So if I can wear my glasses and look studious, it comes in handy. No, I'm just giving my eyes a break from my contact lenses. They were getting really tired. My contacts were getting old, and I was being lazy. So I put in my glasses today. Yay! Everything's kind of going the same, normal. Haven't had any more issues. I know in my last video I talked about an extreme reaction I had to tacos, learned my lesson. I haven't attempted tacos since. I kind of went back to basics this week with my eating, stuck to foods that I know I wouldn't have any problems with. Had some Vietnamese food last night that was absolutely fabulous. It was a grilled chicken stir fry with lemongrass, hold the rice, and it was ended up being a really great moist grilled chicken with onion chunks and green peppers and pea pods. It was wonderful. It was really good. It's going to make like 4 meals for me. So that's great. Tonight for dinner, I made Thai lettuce wraps. I used a recipe on The World According to Eggface. I love that website. I love her recipes. I cook her food all the time. It is extremely pouch friendly. And for anybody who is kind of struggling with what to eat post-op, her website helped me out tremendously. Not only does she have an amazing amount of recipes for protein shakes, she also has great recipes for food that you can cook. Can you see the TV reflection in my... Oh, no, it's my computer reflection in my glasses. That was tripping me out. That's so weird. Sorry. she's got great recipes and great food. A lot of it is gluten-free and natural foods. I made her stuffed pizza bites. It's almost like she calls them kind of like mini crustless quiches. It's, you know, a mixture of eggs and other ingredients. And a lady that I work with, she has chickens, so she farm raises her own eggs and she brings them in to me. And I make this recipe with these farm fresh eggs, and oh, it's so good. It's just to die for, and it makes me feel good because I feel like I'm eating healthy. You know, not a whole lot's going on. Like I said, I have my next doctor's appointment shortly after my 3-month follow-up. So I really want to talk to my doctor. You know, they've never set a weight goal for me. The last time I was there, they said, oh, your progress is doing great. You're losing weight. That's awesome. So I'd really like to talk to them about what to expect as far as, you know, average weight loss I should be experiencing. What does he recommend my goal being? Get some more feedback from him about where I'm at in this process and kind of what's the next steps. Still eating right around 3 to 3.5, sometimes 4 ounces of food, depending on what I'm eating. And it depends what I'm eating too. Sometimes I can eat less. If I'm eating like a more dense protein, like chicken, can't, you know, 3 ounces, I'm probably going to top out at. And some days, man, my pouch just doesn't agree with me and I can't eat very much at all. But, you know, I had a great encounter last week, which kind of really tripped me out. I was in the hallway of my job, and it was, you know, the Bears game. This was this weekend, the playoffs. They lost, but still, I love my Bears. So we were showing our Bears pride last week at work, and we could wear casual clothes as long as we had like a, you know, a team shirt on, something like that. So I had a team sweatshirt, jeans, very casual. I was in the hallways, and this instructor was walking down who, she's a faculty member at the college I work at, and I hadn't seen her for a while. Well, she stopped right in front of me, and she had her back to me, and she was talking to somebody right across from me. So I just tapped her on the shoulder, and I was like, hey, Donna. You know, I haven't seen you for a bit. She turned around and the total shock in her eyes threw me for a loop. She was like, oh my God, I wasn't even talking to you because I didn't even recognize you. I cannot believe how much weight you have lost. How much weight have you lost? I'm like, you know, about 69, you know, almost 70 pounds. She's like, holy cow, you look fantastic. And then she's, you know, she told me I was unrecognizable. So it was really weird to me thinking that I'm an unrecognizable version of my former self, which I know isn't true. I know I'm still recognizable. But just the fact that I've already changed that much, in 11 weeks was pretty, pretty shocking for me, I guess, because, I mean, I know I see the changes, and I look in the mirror and sometimes I'm starting to see myself again. I'm starting to recognize who I am because I'm sure you guys know and can relate to this, but when I was as heavy as I was, I looked in the mirror and I didn't see myself anymore. I saw myself in a fat suit, really. and it didn't feel like I was looking at myself. And that was hard to deal with. So now, as the weight is slowly dropping, I'm starting, it just was this weird epiphany last week where I looked in the mirror and I'm like, wow, like I recognize myself again. I'm starting to, you know, see who I once was. And that makes me extremely happy. And, you know, also to hear that from somebody at my job was kind of crazy too, to hear that I'm unrecognizable. I know it's not true, but still. Pretty nuts. Can give you a head trip sometimes. So I'm just trying to keep it real, keep it myself. I think I'm going to try to do a quick body shot real quick. I haven't done one of those since around Christmas. Let's see if I can get this to work. So hang with me for a second. I got to maneuver some stuff around over here. All right, let's swing this over. All right, let's see if I can do this. This is not going to work very well, I don't think. I didn't test this, and maybe I should have before I did this. Okay. Okay, here we go. So, you can't see my face, but here is body shot. Here's my side. Back side. My front. Again, I don't really have a whole lot of loose skin, just a whole lot of fat still, you know, but that'll come up. My arms, this is a bad shirt for it, but my arms are still really jiggly. This is kind of like the one area I'm worried the most about. So, we'll kind of have to see how that goes as the weight continues to come off. So, yeah, week 11, almost 70 pounds down. So I'm hoping I'll be able to come back for my 3-month video and let you know that I've lost at least another pound, and I am down 70 pounds. That would make me very happy. I had an initial goal to lose 100 pounds in 6 months, and I know that was kind of a crazy goal, but you have to remember I was pretty heavy to start off with. I'm still hoping to make that goal, but I think I'd have to lose like 10 pounds a month. So even if I can come close, I might not hit 100 pounds in 6 months, but if I can come close to it, I'll be a happy camper. I'm already a happy camper with how things are going from the surgery. And I'm glad to see everybody else posting as well. And I'm glad they're doing, I'm glad everybody seems to be doing good and is healthy and losing the weight, because that's the whole reason for going through this in the first place. All right, guys, so it was good chatting again. I look forward to seeing you next week. Please feel free to comment, rate, subscribe, whatever you'd like. And talk to you guys soon. Thanks. Bye.